Hello to all. In this lecture, I am going to talk about treatment strategies for effluent generated by leather industries. Or leather industries are also termed as tanneries. So we can say that here I am going to discuss all the treatment strategies or the treatment methods that are used for the proper treatment of the effluent that generates from such kind of industries. Introduction. Now let's first understand what is tanning. Tanning is the process in which animal skins and hides are treated in such a way so as to produce leather or to produce leather goods like bags, shoes and all that. Now, skins and hides. Skins is the word that is used for the outer covering of the animals of small size like sheep, goat, and hides is also outer covering but of animals of large size like cow, buffalo. So, thus we can say that the conversion of outer skin or outer covering of the animals to produce leather. That process is tanning. And that process permanently alters the protein structure of the skin. And skin becomes more durable, less susceptible to get decomposed, and it also becomes possible to color it so as to make it more attractive. And traditionally, in that tanning process, acidic chemical compound was used and this was named tannin. And after that compound's name, this process gets its name. But later on, due to industrial revolution, tanners start using chromium solution in the tanning process. Tannery or leather industry. This is the place where that tanning process is actually carried out. Process of tanning. That is how the outer covering of animals or their skins, hides are converted into usable leather. There are certain steps are there and these are firstly procuring animal skin. That is the extracting skin from the animals. Thereafter, such skin is cured to prevent its deterioration. And thereafter, there are steps like soaking, liming, removal of extraneous tissue, deliming, baiting, drenching, pickling. The steps from soaking to pickling, these all are termed as beam house operations. Thus, the skin that is extracted from the animal, this is firstly cured and thereafter specific treatments are given to it. And these all are the treatments from soaking to pickling. And after the pickling stage, proper tanning is done. And there are different methods of tanning that we are going to discuss in this lecture. Process of tanning. As I have already told you, there are different steps in the process of tanning. Let's discuss all these steps in detail. First one is procuring animal skin. That means the extracting the skin from the animals. And this is animal is killed and skinned before the body heat leaves the tissues. That is when any animal die. Then after some time its skin leaves the tissues to which that skin is attached, and before that leaving that skin is removed from the animal body. And such kind of task is mainly done by the tanners. Tanners are the persons which are involved in tanning industries, or this can be obtained in the slaughterhouse, in the farms, or this can also be procured from the fur traders and all that. Next task is curing. And that curing process is used to preserve the hides from the bacterial decomposition. Actually, bacterial growth at the time between procuring and further processing of skin, that bacterial growth is prevented. Or we can say that when animal skin is procured and before the tanning process, there are chances that bacteria may attack over that skin. In the skin, there are components like protein, and there are chances of putrefaction of that protein. Okay, so the methods which are used for curing are, first one method is by salting. And animal skin, if we see the composition of animal skin, that is comprised of mainly 60 to 65% water, 30 to 32% protein, 10% fat, 0.5 to 1% minerals. So from there we can say that the protein content is of major concern. It is in large quantity in the animal skin, and there are chances of putrefaction or anaerobic decomposition of that protein to sulfur rich compounds like mercaptans, hydrogen sulfide, and these are highly foul smelling compounds. This can make the skin, this can deteriorate the skin. So to prevent the bacterial growth, that salting process is used. Salt removes the water from the hides and skins. The skin becomes dehydrated, and when it becomes dehydrated, and that is done by the salt by the process of osmotic pressure. And when becomes when the skin becomes dewatered, then it becomes unsuitable for the microbial growth. So bacteria can't grow and they cannot deteriorate the skin. And there are different ways by which that curing process is performed. First one is, this can be done by wet salting, and in that process hides are heavily salted and these are pressed into packs for about 30 days. And in the case of brine curing, the hides are agitated in salt water bath and for about 16 hours. And here the salt concentration is around 3% to 26%. And besides that, there is another method of curing also. That means the skins can be preserved by applying low temperature. Actually, we have to create such kind of conditions which inhibit the growth of bacteria or inhibit the growth of microbes so that they do not deteriorate the quality of the skin or to decompose the skin. So here, low temperature, salting, these all conditions prevent the growth of the bacteria and in this way keep the skin preserved before their further processing. Pre-tanning or beam house operations. Now, after curing the skins, there are different steps from which the desired characteristics are bring to the skin, and after that the proper tanning process is done. Now, these all steps are also termed as pre-tanning steps because these are carried out before the actual tanning process, and these are also termed as beam house operations. And first one step is soaking. After here the skins are dehaired, that means the hairs are removed, degreased, the grease or oily content of the skin is removed, desalted, the salt that was used in the curing process, that salt is removed, and thereafter skin is soaked in water for a period of about 6 hours to 2 days. Actually, in the further process, moist skin is required therefore it is kept soaked in water for that time. And while soaking, to prevent the skin from the bacterial attack or from the microbial attack, from the fungal attack, biocides are used like dithiocarbamates, 2-thiocyanomethyl thiobenzothiazole. That compound prevent the growth of molds. Thus, leather is properly protected from the attack of microbes while soaking. Thus, here you can see that those chemicals have been used, and the effluent that generates from the tanning industry that may contain these chemicals. Now, the next step is liming. After soaking, the hides are treated with milk of lime. Milk of lime is calcium hydroxide. This is basic in nature, and this milk of lime is supplemented with sodium sulfide, cyanides, amines. These are sharpening agents. These are disulfide reducing agents. That treatment actually removes the hairs and all the keratinous materials. Keratinous material, that means that is comprised of keratin protein that are present or attached on the skin. In the keratin protein, disulfide links are there between the cysteine amino acids, and these reducing agents break down these links, and sharpening agents also contribute in unhairing. That means these sharpening agents as well as that milk of lime that ultimately removes all the keratinous materials or the hairs from the skins. Now the next step is again unhairing and scudding. Unhairing agents are specifically used after carrying out the liming. If hairs are there, then these are removed by unhairing and scudding. Here unhairing agents are used: sodium sulfide, sodium hydroxide, sodium hydrosulfide, calcium hydrosulfide, dimethylamine, sodium sulfidate. These all are kind of agents or chemicals which are used especially for unhairing the skin. Skin is also removed mechanically by the use of machines, and at the end it is also removed by hand by using a dull knife, and that process of removal by mechanical means is termed as scudding. So ultimately all the hairs are removed by using these processes. Thus you can see that there are so many chemicals are used in these processes, and so the effluent that generates from tanneries that may contain these chemicals, and these hazardous chemicals must be removed, such kind of effluent. Now up to that, the skin has been made moist and the hairs or any keratinous materials that are attached to the skin, these have been removed by the earlier processes. Now the next step is de-liming and baiting. Now depending upon the use of leather, that means which type of characteristics have to be bring into the leather, these hides are given enzymatic treatment to soften it, and that treatment is termed as baiting. Enzymes act properly when the pH is low, but earlier in the liming treatment we have used calcium hydroxide. It was basic in nature, pH was high, so pH has to be brought down before using the enzymes, and this is done by removing the milk of lime that we used earlier, and that process of removal of lime is termed as de-liming. And next process is pickling. After the enzymatic treatment or baiting, the The skins and hides are treated with common salt and then with sulfuric acid. That treatment is used when further mineral tanning has to be done. Actually, that tanning process is of different types that we will see later on. These are chrome tanning, vegetable tanning, mineral tanning. And here, if mineral tanning has to be done, then the skins and hides are firstly treated with common salt and thereafter with sulfuric acid. That sulfuric acid bring the pH, that sulfuric acid is a strong acid that drop down the pH of the skin, and that treatment is termed as pickling. Actually, the along with the sulfuric acid, salt is used because salt penetrates the hides very fast, at a speed twice as much as the speed of the acid to penetrate, and that action prevent the ill effect of the sudden drop in pH. Sulfuric acid can drop the pH down at a very fast rate that can damage the skin. So to protect the skin, salt is also used along with sulfuric acid. So these all are the different beam house operations or pre-tanning operations that are carried out to mainly to remove the skin, to remove the hairs that are present on the skin, or to make that skin soft, or to enzymatically soften the skin and all that. Types of tanning processes. Now, after carrying out the pre-tanning processes, a tanning process is done, and there are different processes by which that tanning is carried out, but mainly there are two processes, and these are chrome tanning and vegetable tanning. Chrome tanning. Now, that chrome tanning process is carried out by adding trivalent chromium compound, that is chromium sulfate and sodium bicarbonate. Here, trivalent chromium sulfate, this is very effective and efficient tanning agent, and sodium bicarbonate is necessary to raise the pH. Actually, after the pickling step, pH gets lower down, and here high pH is required. At high pH, that trivalent chromium compound undergoes processes like oleation, and that ultimately gives rise to polychromium compounds. And these polychromium compounds have a tendency to form cross linkage with the collagen fibers. These polychromium species get attached to the free carboxyl groups of these collagen fibers, and that cross linkage makes the hide resistant to bacteria and high temperature. And the chromium tanned hide contains about 2 to 3% of dry weight of chromium. Vegetable tanning. For carrying out the vegetable tanning, hides are kept immersed in tannin liquor. Tannin liquor contains tannins. Tannins are polyphenol chemicals that occur naturally in the bark and leaves of many plants. And in that tannin liquor, hides are kept immersed for several weeks in a series of vats or containers with increasing concentration of tannins. That means hides are given different treatment with different concentration of tannin liquor. And thereafter, tannins bind to the collagen proteins and finally coat the hides and make these hides less water soluble and more resistant to bacterial attack, and the hides are also become more flexible. And vegetable tanned hides are not generally very flexible, and these are used for the formation of luggage, furniture, footwear, belts and other clothing accessories. And as compared to the vegetable tanned hides, chromium tanned hides are more flexible, and these are light leathers. But here vegetable tan leather is heavy leather, and that is used for the formation of these items. After carrying out the tanning process, finishing is done, and in the finishing process, stuffing and fat liquoring and dyeing of leather is done. And in the stuffing and fat liquoring, the tanned leather is incorporated with oil and grease, and so that the leather becomes soft, pliable and resistant to tear. Dyeing is usually done for providing different colors to the leather, and that is done by using synthetic dyes. The references for this presentation are these. Thank you.